Hello there, it's a starting gamer playing Fable Anniversary, which came out in Steam today, which is September 11, 2014. So let's just jump into the menu. I'm playing with a controller, by the way. I haven't played Fable in ages, the first Fable game that is. So let's just go check the options. It's just the standard options, really. Naturally, I have subtitles on. Let's see. By the way, I'm leaving VSync on. Normally, I turn that off, but I just tried to turn it off before, and it caused the game to go black. Black screen. Stopped responding. So I'll just leave it on for now. And let's get on with the game, hey? I'm thinking I might play it heroic as I've already beaten the game in the default. But I don't know. I think I'll go heroic. If I'm really sick of it, I can only start again. Okay, let's get on with it then.
Deep in the forest of Albion lay the small town of Oakvale, unchanged by time and untouched by the sword. Here lived a boy and his family, a boy dreaming of greatness, of one day being a hero. Sometimes he imagined himself as a noble knight or a powerful wizard. And other times he dreamt he'd be an evil warrior. But in all his dreams of greatness, he could not possibly imagine the power of the destiny that lay before him.
Come on, wake up! Daydreaming again, were you? Just like your mother, mind always wandering. Well, let it wander off to find your sister, will you? She's out playing by the Barrowfield gate. Remember, you haven't given her a birthday present yet. Don't tell me you forgot to get her one. Well, I'm not bailing you out this time, son. I tell you what, I'll give you a gold piece for each good deed you do around Oakvale. That should be enough to buy her a present. Now, get moving and stay out of trouble.
Hello, lad. I'm a trader. I wander the world buying and selling wares, especially to fine folk like your good self. Some little girl I saw said you have a sister, and it's her birthday. And it seems you haven't got her a present yet. It just so happens that I have a rather nice box of sweets here. guaranteed to put a smile on any sister's face for only 3 gold pieces. Maybe later, but hurry before I eat them myself. Remember, 3 gold coins, that's all they cost.
Mind how you go, kid. Might as well play as much as you can.
Honestly, where's that filthy layabout husband of mine? With some woman I don't doubt. I run his house, bring up his children, and what do I get in return? Nothing. If you find him, let me know, won't you?
Goodness, listen, lad, could you do me a favour? I've got to, you know, answer a call of nature. Oh, stay here and watch this stock for me. There's a good lad. Just stand between those two stacks and don't move. I'll put a good word in for you when I get back. Right, won't be long.
My cousin says that the barrels in these warehouses might have stuff in them. Quick, while he's away, smash his barrels up and see what's inside.
Oh dear, I don't know what to do. I tend to play naughty characters, evil characters. I'm thinking. I think I'll probably break them. Such a bad boy. Very diet bad, but still.
Unless you're too scared. Unless you're just a big blubbing girl.
Come on, let's go and break stuff.
Are you just gonna stand there like a lemon?
But being good is so boring.
Wouldn't you prefer to be smashing thing? Wouldn't you prefer to be smashing thing?
Come on, there's still time before he gets back.
Fun at all.
Fine. Have your stupid good deed then.
Well, since I was apparently attacking the wrong things, I guess I'm going to just be the good guy by default.
Excellent. Thanks, lad. You've done me a big favour. I'll let your dad know what a splendid watchman you made.
Oh well.
Sorry, son, not the time for...
I'm just dealing with this brat. He was irritating me, playing with my sister and her stupid teddy bear. Now he won't give it to me, just because I said I'd rip its stupid head off. I told him, if he doesn't do what I say, I'm going to make his life a misery. Ah! Ow! Ah! I'm sorry. I'll leave him alone. Just please don't hit me again.
Thank you. You stopped him good. Thank you. Here, I'll let you look after Rosie. She'll be safe with you.
Look, right, got you, you little ruffian. I've heard reports that you've been doing bad deeds. Destruction of that sort of behaviour. If you were older, you'd be apprehended. You need to decide if behaving like... I'll leave it at that for now.
He's an unpredictable chap, isn't he?
Hey?
You never can tell with that kid.
What? I've never even met this woman. Who is she? Look, Sonny, keep your mouth shut about this, right? My wife's at home with our little ones, and I'm supposed to be working. But a man should be entitled to do what he likes, don't you think? Tell you what, if you keep this little secret, I'll give you a gold piece. Just don't tell my wife. I can't let her find out about this. You scrumptious little thing.
Singing as high as a cotton singing.
My bad reputation is enough to a very good start, unfortunately. There's just some things I'm not a big fan of.
So
I'm gonna report him, naughty boy, that he is.
You never can.
Where's that filthy layabout husband of mine? With some woman I don't doubt. I run his house, bring up his children, and what do I get in return? Nothing. If you find him, let me know, won't you? You have? Right. I'm gonna turn him into Balverine food. Thank you, young sir, for telling me.
Wait till I get my hands on that pig! You filthy swine! I ought to chop them right off!
We were rehearsing a play. Yeah, that's all it was.
Don't insult me anymore! My mother was right about you. Well, if you think I'm going to cook and clean for you while you're out having a good time with your strumpet, you've got another thing coming. Who is she anyway? Some tart from the village? Younger than me, is she? You filthy swine! I ought to chop them right off.
We were rehearsing a play. Yeah, that's all it was.
Don't insult me anymore. My mother was right about you. Well, if you think I'm going to cook and clean for you...
I think it just goes on a loop. So, I'm done with that. Going off for the last deed they need. There's that kid.
I'm a man of my word. So, but if you think that I'll turn a blind eye to your mischief... Look, try to keep out of trouble, please. For me. So, have you got enough money for a gift for Teresa?
Where's that kid? I mean, I'm supposed to give her her bear, right?
I'm not sure what to make of you, lad.
Your stuffing.
Dinner. Kids' faces are extremely creepy in this game. Actually, all faces are kind of creepy in this game, but kids especially, they're just kind of like bobbleheads almost. It's just weird looking.
A man am I, but if you think that I'll turn a blind look, try to. Well, I think you may have enough.
I think I'll talk to the sisters something before I turn in, maybe. I don't know. Never mind. Should probably just say you remember my birthday or something like that.
Ooh, you're lucky I've still got these sweets. Quickly, give me 3 gold pieces now, and they're yours. Young sir, they are yours. Wish your sister a happy birthday from me now, won't you?
I'm not sure what to make of you.
Hello, little brother. I hope you haven't forgotten what day it is, like you did last year. I'm sorry if I woke you up last night. It was another of those dreams. I was standing in this field when something happened, but I can't remember what. Never mind that, though. I'm still waiting for my present. I knew you were going to bring me chocolates. It's just like my dream. Come on, let's go home. Mother will be back for my party any minute now.
Wait, there's something wrong.
Bandits!
It's really happening. They're here. You've got to hide.
One. Evil had come to Oakvale. Bandits wielding torches and steel, slaying and burning all in their path. Blood-red flames lit the night as the villagers screamed and begged for mercy, and soon their bodies filled the streets. Then the raiders reached the last house where the boy and his family lived. It was them they had slaughtered so many to find. The father fought to protect his kin, but he was no warrior, and fell mortally wounded. The bandits ripped the house apart, but could not find the boy. Through torture and threats, his mother and sister remained silent, and their furious attackers took them both. From the nearby woods, the boy watched as all he knew was taken away. His whole life was crushed to ashes. He was alone.
Just the kind of, kind of just generic, isn't it? Well, getting on with the game.
We must leave. It's not safe here. They're all dead. You don't want to join them, do you? Then give me your hand. I thought you'd have a stronger stomach than that. Come on. Save your energy, boy. It's not me you want to fight. You might not realize it, but I just saved your life. There's nothing left for you in Oakvale. And if you'd stayed, you'd be as dead as the rest of them. Come with me. My name is Maze. And I'm the head of the Guild of Heroes. You must have heard of it. You'll find nowhere safer in all of Albion, nor a better place to call your home. And if it's vengeance you want, you'll need the training only we can offer. Here we are. I'll introduce you to the Guildmaster. He'll be your guide from now on.
Well, that was a rather short scene between loading screens.
I have a new student for you. Put him in the dorm upstairs, with the girl.
You don't look much like hero material to me, but Maze knows what he's doing, I suppose. Well, follow me then. You'll be sharing this room with Whisper, one of our brightest young pupils. She's playing in the woods right now, but you'll meet her in the morning. For now, you should get some sleep. Your training starts tomorrow.
It's time to wake up. You must be my roommate. Shorter than I expected. My name's Whisper. I've been here for a month. Had the room to myself till now, too. But that's all right. You know you talk in your sleep. Sounded like a bad nightmare. Happened to a lot the first week. Some don't even last that long. You won't either if you don't get moving. The Guildmaster is waiting for us in the map room. You don't want to be late on your first day. Follow me. Looks like the Guildmaster got tired of waiting for you. He's probably at the training grounds across the river. Let's go! These are the main dorms. Glad we don't have to sleep in here. Smells a bit.
Yeah.
Hmm.
journey's length is of no consequence. The Oracle must be protected.
How can you be so sure? We might need you here. Who knows what battles we might face?
The signs are too strong to ignore, and the Northern Wastes have been too long isolated from the Guild. There is much I may learn there.
Well, I hope nobody thinks you're running away from a fight, trying to cheat death again. You know how people talk.
Talk is of no matter to me. May death close his eyes to you, Maze.
What are you waiting for? Come in. That was Scythe. He was a great hero once, back when he had flesh on his bones and blood in his veins. He's just a shell now. What does he know of the choices we have to make, of what it takes to get things done? No, boy. You're supposed to report to the Guildmaster, not me. You can always find out where he is by looking at your map.
We're discussing whether I'm the fastest apprentice in this guild. I ran to the demon door and back in 50 seconds. Beat that. Right then, get to the demon door and back and talk to me in 50 seconds. No chance. I'm the fastest guild apprentice by miles.
I guess I ran the wrong way, huh? Oops. There it is. Well, I'll try it again. Assuming he lets me anyway.
You're the most arrogant, that's for sure.
You again? You didn't do too well. Right then, get to the demon. I'm the fastest!
Your path is dark. Only a light will reveal.
Just barely beat him.
That showed you, didn't it?
Big deal. Running's for idiots anyway.
Finally, pride.
All right, lad. It's time to see if you've any potential. Get in the ring. Now then, I want you to hit that dummy as hard as you can. Just keep going till I tell you to stop. Making much of an impact there, are you? Here, try with this. That's more like it. When you destroy an enemy like this dummy, it drops an experience orb. These orbs contain the knowledge gained from killing the creature. It's very important that you collect these orbs, or you won't learn anything. Now pick it up. Well done, lad. Now then, tomorrow we'll... That's the guild alarm. Sounds like there might be something loose in the woods.
This is a good opportunity to test your spirit. I'll wait for you at the Guildwood's entrance while you deal with the problem. Once you're done, we can talk about starting your training.
very standard tutorial quest.
Good work, lad. Those beetles can be a damn nuisance. Here, I think you've earned yourself some pocket money for that. If you want more gold, I'm sure the servants could use your help with something. Or you can get an early night. The guild was now the boy's life. The memory of the Oakvale flames still scorched his mind, but soon he had no thought other than training, and he became stronger and more agile with every passing year. His days were filled with grueling exercises, the nights with study in the library. Finally, he was ready to become a guild apprentice, just as Maze had foreseen. The real training was about to begin.
Get out of bed, lazy bones. We were supposed to meet the guildmaster on the other side of the river, but that was an hour ago. We better get going. Race you there.
I guess I kind of screwed up. I should have said no before, because then I would have been able to make a little pocket money, I think. Oh well, I suppose that's enough of a video. I've recorded for a little while. Nothing very exciting, but this is just an intro video, so goodbye then.